Bustling day.
And doing this.
Urban said Araya's apprentice went north of the river. Hopefully not too far. That must be Neltuk, living out of that tower. Looks like it's made out of cross or city. Neltuk?
Who are you? How did you find me?
Burgrund told me you'd be out here.
He's persistent. I've told that Osteram 1,000 times. I don't need to buy anything.
And I'm not selling. I just need to find Araya.
Well, you won't. She's gone where only shamans can tread. She seeks guidance from the voice in the blue light. That is her task. And the task she gave me is to observe the daemon's work. To stop it spreading, if I can. But what can I do about these towers? In only a few weeks, they've sprouted throughout the cut. The daemon's energy pulses from them. Rallies the machines, even repairs them.
Aratok said this daemon was frenzying machines?
Look there. Those with the purple markings. They belong to the daemon. They're stronger, more dangerous.
I've seen something like this before. A corruption. But it wasn't from your daemon.
You have? Well, then you know more than I do. These towers, were they part of your corruption?
No. Those are new to me, too.
Like I said, they empower the daemon's machines. They must be stopped.
Will you tell me where Araya went?
You ask a lot of questions.
Only when I'm not getting the answers I need.
There's but one voice Araya wants to hear right now, and it isn't yours. I'm sorry.
All right. You want to stop the spread of the daemon's work? I know how to get started. With my bow and spear.
Outlander, wait. Won't you tell me your name?
Aloy.
Good. If you fall to the daemon's machines, at least I can properly recount your efforts to Araya.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. But I won't fall. And when I'm done, you're gonna tell me where she is. Interesting. Maybe I could override it.
Thank you.
Hello?
Let's talk about Araya.
Now we know how to deal with the machines in the towers. The daemon's next.
Perhaps Araya should meet you after all. What she truly seeks is hope. After what I just saw, you could show her that. She's in retreat beyond those mountains, the ice rasps. You'll have to walk the shaman's path to get there. You'll know you've reached the end when you come to a shrine, a great machine covered in blue gleam. Shamans who complete the path take a piece of it as reward. If you make it that far, you should too. You'll have earned it.
You said something about blue gleam at the end of the shaman's path?
A crystal that builds on the bodies of machines in the oldest ice. We Banuk believe it's the stuff of the blue light, frozen as it escapes their shells. You might be more interested that merchants will trade well for it.
Bergrin told me you're Araya's apprentice.
In her absence, I serve the chieftain and his werak as an advisor, a scout, a speaker for the blue light.
A lot of responsibilities.
I don't know if I can live up to Araya's example, but I have to try. I owe her that much. She took a chance on me. An aspiring shaman from the edge of the world. No one else would.
Were you with Araya when they attacked the mountain?
I wish I had been, even with all that happened. I'm no warrior, though, so she bid me wait. When Araya and the chieftain returned, I saw them argue bitterly. I don't know what about exactly. Then she came to me, gave me my task, and left us.
How do I cross this shaman's path?
Go to the ice rasps. Then follow the markers through the ice caves and the waterfalls, and make the climb to the shrine. But be careful. The path is meant to be an ordeal, the final trial of a young shaman's training.
And I'll find Araya at the end of it?
No. She goes further up. Somewhere inside the mountain. If you see her, would you tell her I have faith she will hear the voice again?
All right. I guess I'm off to the ice rasps to find this shaman's path. Good. I can use this. There. That must be where the water's coming from. Looks like something the old ones built. Tough, but I'm used to it. Yeah.
Canis Americanus, the magnificent American black bear, brought to you by Montana Recreations.
Beautiful. How fierce you must have been.
That fur. You never even felt the cold, did you?
If he hadn't preserved you, would anyone even know you'd disappeared?
I hate to interrupt.
Oh, I... Yes. Hello, I... Well, an outlander at the Shrine of Forgotten Beasts. Welcome. I'm Enjuk.
Aloy. The Shrine of... what?
When the old world still breathed, a great man built a tiny totem to this beast and stored the visage inside. When the totem is placed on the pedestal, the animal is painted onto the empty air, and the beast lives again. Well, almost.
There are 7 pedestals. Where are the other 6 figurines?
I found this one in the wilds. Remembered the indentations in the pedestals here, and saw how they matched the base of the totem. But as you say, it's 1 of 7, isn't it? The great Montana Recreations must have made more, but time has scattered them.
So these totems, the images they show are of animals that no longer exist. They're gone, like the old ones.
So it seems. To think such magnificent creatures are lost to us that we never even knew they were here. We rely as much on beasts as we do on machines. For food, for warmth, but do we study them with the same fervor? Yeah, I do. For example, I have this theory about foxes. Why do foxes have red fur? Think about what they eat.
Meat?
Raw meat. Bloody meat, see? Natural causation, logical connections. It only makes sense.
You've thought a lot more about foxes than I have. You said a great man made these figurines?
Indeed. He was, I believe, a student of the natural world. Like me. But surpassing my abilities 1,000 times over. The great Montana Recreations. Perhaps the finest natural scholar the old world ever produced. His voice claims responsibility for the totems, the vessels for the knowledge he accumulated. I share his desire to understand the beasts, to catalog their behaviors and preserve their images. I like to flatter myself that I'm an apprentice of sorts, carrying on his work. Someday, perhaps, if I am persistent, I can earn his name, Enjuk Recreations.
I should get going.
Of course, of course. I've taken up so much of your time already. But I don't suppose you could keep an eye out for more figurines?
If I run across any, I'll bring them your way.
Ursus Americanus. The magnificent American black bear. Brought to you by Montana Recreations.
How would you like to find yourself cornered by that thing?
I suspect I'd like it very much indeed. What a beautiful beast you were.
This'll last.
Thank you.
Tasty. If Ikri's not coming back...
She'll be back. She never falters.
But if she has, then I'm the one who can throw a spear the farthest.
And I'm the one who can climb ice the fastest.
You have passed one test. The next test is of silence.
What are your hunters doing so far out here?
We are of the White Teeth, come down from the jawbone of Benur to test those who would run with us.
A test? In those hunting grounds?
No, it is an ordeal. Survive upon the glacier in the knife trail, as our ancestors did. It's been a harsh season. Two have yet to return. We shall wait. Then we shall bless their attempt. Then we shall leave.
What does this ordeal involve?
To scale the glacier's face and endure 4 days and four nights, sustained only from the frozen ground of the machines. Our shaman has blessed the ordeal and permitted their harvest.
Metal to fashion weapons. The rest is forbidden.
What about the two who haven't returned?
It was their ordeal to face alone. Their life or death. Those who return know the White Teeth run alongside them. Those who do not know the White Teeth marked their attempt.
How generous. You're from Benur. Do you know about Aratak and Araya?
Strong names, indeed. They have many songs. But there is a reason they roam out here, in the Cut, and not among the Great Waraks. This obsession with Thunder's Drum will be their undoing.
So who are the White Teeth?
Warriors. The first and the best. All young hunters hungry for the fight seek to run with us. Now the machines are angered. There was always fighting. We are well served, eh, Shaman?
Every day, lightning cracks in the smoke of battle. Every night, a new name to honor in song.
Aren't you even going to look for your missing hunters?
In time. As months pass, the Meltwater often carries the bodies out.
Unbelievable. If there's a chance they're alive, then I'll look for them.
Even if they did still live, they will not accept your aid, Outlander. To us, survival is sacred.
Nothing else can be relied upon.
We'll see.
Sometimes I make horrible shapes.
Survival sacred. So they leave people to die?
Beware the machines.
That away. must be the cave that Shaman told me about. Long way down. Not natural either. I might not be alone down here. Those are the metal guards. Flying machine over a little. Perhaps my focus can help me. Not so grounded after all. Now I can get across. There's the door lock. I'll need to configure it.
If those punk technicians think I'm gonna sleep on them waltzing in here and screwing around with the drone routines, they have seriously underestimated my sense of mission. Let's just reset that hololock. Echo, Sierra, echo.
Can my focus show me anything? This'll come in handy.
I didn't ask for a bunch of flying cameras. I need security, not surveillance. And security means firepower. As God is my witness, I will not be caught squirting blanks if and when a major act of terrorism desecrates these facilities.
Shouldn't be hard to remove. I'll show it to that shaman when I'm back in Song's Edge. Got too much already. Mm-hmm. to this. I will improve my spear, huh? Scrabbling a bit. So this thing will improve my spear, huh? Fistful of blue beans worth braving the cold. I think I'm in the clear. Blue gloom. Taking that. I think I should turn around.
Yeah.
fresh as it comes. Glad I found this. And one of these. Cold. Very cold. Save this for later. Slow and quiet does it. Not just the new crew. Thank you.
deep din. Silenced by rising waters.
Is this what you...
Hush, hush! A shaman's secrets are not spoken aloud.
Is this what you wanted me to find?
Bind it to your spear. Use it to attach this for now. You'll find more, I'm sure.
Why are you helping me?
The blue light is fading. The machine songs are ending. And what does the Conclave do? They sit, they chant, they observe. No more. We must fight for it. And you? You are a fighter. We share a cause.
I'm not sure we do. I'm not even sure what the cause is. But I'm grateful.
No need for thanks. Only action.
Now I can attach modification parts to my spear. Works for me. Might as well get started improving my spear.
No more music. Blood, stop that. Sakuli will want this.
Thank you.
Easy, easy. These mountains must be the ice rasps. The shaman's path begins somewhere up above. Blue gleam. I'll be taking that. Might need that. Huh. quick way down. Maybe I can trade this blue gleam. Watch my fingers. Grapes. it. Nothing to see here. Nutritious. Somebody wanted in. Nearly blew this entire ledge off just to get through the door.
Flooding detected. Evacuation recommended. Overflow.
The overflow basin. Is that the dip?